And I just have a few brief comments and remarks to make. The first thing I want to say is, like many of you that are here, getting here was not easy. And you, most of you are here because you have persevered and you've had a mission in life to improve not just your life, but the life of your family. And I want you all to know that while I sit here today as mayor of Long Beach, not too long ago, about, I came to the U.S. about 30 years ago or so, 32 years ago. I was 5 years old, and when my family came to the U.S., we immigrated here to the U.S. So I am an immigrant by birth, and I came to the U.S., like many of you, for a hope of a better life. And I grew up from five all the way till I got to college in a very tough situation. My family didn't have a lot of money. No one in my family had ever gone to college. 8 or 9 of us lived in an apartment, usually at the same time. And I remember oftentimes we'd have a one-bedroom apartment. There were always 9, 10, sometimes more people than that in that apartment. We'd welcome people into our homes. My mother always worked, I'm sure like many of your mothers or many of you, 2 jobs or 3 jobs at once just to feed the family and to make sure that we were okay as a community. And so getting here, graduating, like all of you are doing today, or like I was able to do when I got to college, is a journey and a struggle. And it's one that you should all recognize that you didn't just get here by yourself. It was because of your faith in God, or it's because of your family that you are here. And the one thing that was always very important to me as I went through my experience is, even though it was tough, even though I had a lot of top ramen growing up, the macaroni and cheese is, you know, a big part of my diet, the one thing that I always appreciated about my mother or my family was we had a loving family. No matter how poor we were, there was a lot of, we were not poor for love. We were not poor as a family because we had a richness of supporting each other. And so as you graduate today, think about, as you walk up here and you receive that final congratulatory remarks and the final handshake of your graduation, think about your family and all the people that got you here. Now, I want to also share with you one other thing. I graduated from college, I went on to grad school, and I got into education. Before I became mayor, I spent 10 years as a college professor. I've taught at USC, I've taught at Long Beach City College, and I've taught at Cal State Long Beach. And the one thing that has been unique in all of those experiences is that there is nothing more important, in my opinion, for us as a country or as a community to invest in than to invest in education and ensuring that people have access to getting a certificate, a college degree, to become a nurse, to get involved in their community. This is the most important thing that you can do to improve your life. There is nothing more important than graduating and getting an education, and I want to thank you for taking that step and making our country a better place by doing so at the same time. I also want to just mention to you that for all of you entering this new phase of your life, be excited about your future and don't let anyone ever tell you that you can't do it. Don't let anyone ever tell you you can't do it, or you're too young, or you don't have enough money, or you're too this, or you don't have this. Be bold and move forward with strength and dignity and confidence. I'm going to tell you a very short story. When I've been teaching for about 8 or 9 years, and I was teaching at Cal State Long Beach. I was involved in my neighborhood. I actually live not too far from where we are right now. And 5 years ago, I thought, you know, I think I'm going to run for the city council. And what everybody told me, everyone told me, they said, you're too young. You know, you're a Latino. Latino hasn't really been elected in this part of town. Why don't you wait your turn? You don't have enough experience. And so what did I do, of course? I decided to run anyways. And I won that election. And had I not won that election 5 years ago, at first on the council, I would not have had the chance then now to run for mayor. And I'm extremely proud of the fact for all of you that are here that today I sit as mayor as the youngest person in the history of the city to be elected mayor and the first Latino person of color to serve as mayor. And that's important. I tell you that because no matter the color of your skin, what you look like, who you love, your socioeconomic status, you can achieve your dreams if you work hard, and most importantly, get an education, which is what you're doing today, and I want to thank you for that. So thank you again for all that work. I want to also give you one piece of advice that's, in my opinion, the best piece of advice that I've ever received in my life. You know, I, unfortunately, like many of you, my grandmother isn't here anymore, but I live by one thing she always told me, and it's the one thing I credit more than anything else that has allowed me to succeed in college, to get my doctorate, to get elected mayor of Long Beach. And the one thing she would always tell me was so simple, but it's so important. She would always tell me to be kind. To be kind and to be a good person. And let me tell you something. There is no anger and being upset at the world and being mean to other people will get you nowhere. Turn the emotion you feel, turn the emotion that you feel, or perhaps the injustices of the world, and turn them into kindness to other people. There is nothing in this world more powerful than using the injustice that we face in this world and then turning that into kindness and doing good to other people in your community. I believe in those words because it's what Martin Luther King taught us. For those of us that are of faith, it's what the good book teaches us every single day. And I bet it's also what all of your parents and family members taught us as well too. And so think about in your daily lives as you go on to your career, what can I do today to be a good person? What can I do today to be kind to somebody else that may not expect it? And that for me has been the one thing I try to do, even in politics, which is not necessarily always the most kind place to be or to be involved in.